Hi everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is a little bit different. Today I will be discussing my monthly favorites. My favorites of the month. My favorites of August. And the reason I'm doing this video, I have multiple reasons if you're wondering. You're probably not, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. One, so I can look back on it way into the future, when I'm older. Two, I just thought it'd be fun. I don't know, that you guys might enjoy it. And you'll kind of get to know me. And yeah, those are my only reasons. So, the first category we have is music favorites. The first week was predominantly filled with a band called Somersault. There might be an S at the end of that, I'm not sure. Especially with their song, Revin My CJ7.
If I can't get into heaven, I best be Revin My CJ7. Now ain't that the lie?
Chef's Kiss. I love it so much. It's a really great song. That's all I can say. It's a great song for the morning, especially. I would really suggest checking out their band. It's so great. Go check them out. Next is, like, the middle of the month was filled with a genre of music called indie pop. I love it so much. Lots of mxmtoon and Conan Gray.
What?
Oh my god. Meant to say Conan Gray, but then I said Conan Gray instead of Bon Iver. mxmtoon and Conan Gray.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. mxmtoon and Conan Gray are fantastic artists. I love them with my whole heart. They're both amazing. Maya, who is mxmtoon, recently came out with a song called Bon Iver, not Conan Gray.
Playing Bon Iver on late night drives, my window, moon, and fireflies.
I love that song as well as her song Almost Home. Both of those are just so nice. I love all of them. I love all of her songs. They're so good. But those would be my top two favorites because I don't want to ramble on forever. Okay, next I'll discuss my favorite Conan songs. I'm going to try and keep this short. I love every single one of his songs wholeheartedly. First we have Comfort Crowd.
My breath's getting short and I'm unsteady. Welling up in tears as I lay upon your belly, telling you I'm fine, I don't really need nobody. But you say through a sigh that I said that lie already.
It's like her in mood, you know? That's how I'm feeling today, and basically every day. Next is The Other Side.
You keep on crying, babe, I don't mind. I'll keep on staring at the clock, trying to pass time.
It's very soft, I quite like it. It's just really nice. It's one of his older songs, but it's still on Spotify and like Apple Music and stuff. So, that's really great. And then I also love The King.
You like me, obviously. So why are you trying to leave when you know that I'm the king? Cause I'm supreme. Choose me.
The Other Side and The King are very different in terms of sound. They are both still equally as amazing, and like, The King just immediately puts me in a good mood. I love it. The Other Side, not so much. It just makes me think of my friend. Yeah. This next song is a bit random. I don't know why I put it at the end, or like close to the end, but this song has just kind of been throughout the whole month, and it is Invisible String by Taylor Swift.
Green was the color of the grass where I used to read at Centennial Park.
It's very underrated, but it is still so good. I really, really, really love it. For some reason, it reminds me of Conan Gray's song, Heather. Just like with the, like it's very specific in the beginning, like green was the color of the grass, like if, you know? And then with Heather, it's like very specific. It was the 3rd of December. It wasn't just some winter day, you know? They just remind me of each other. They don't really have like a similar meaning at all or sound, but like that just makes me immediately think, they immediately make me think of each other. And then to finish the month off, I've been listening to lots of old Conan Gray songs on YouTube, his original songs, and as well as covers. I've been loving his song Treehouse.
High above the leaves bring apple juice and freezy.
That song is just absolute perfection. And then also his song Sometime, I think is the name of it.
Fade out to my memories, look into the sun.
That song is also good. Yeah, I would definitely recommend checking out all those songs. I'll put a list in the description of the video, so you can like screenshot it and then go check out those songs because you need to. Next are fashion favorites. These jeans, I love them to death. They're thrifted. I don't usually buy any clothes from regular stores. It's mostly all thrifted. It's just cheaper, more affordable, and it saves the planet. It, you know, I just love it. It's also like a really fun thing to do if you're bored. But don't do it now, because most of you probably live in the US, where the coronavirus is going crazy, so never mind. Don't do it right now. After this is all over, let's all meet up and go thrifting, okay? But not right now. Next is this striped sweater. It's also thrifted. I really love like kind of the muted tones of it. I've been getting so many compliments on it, like every time I wear it. You know? I don't know. It's just really cute and I love it so much. And then next is this sweatshirt. It has like this like fake little, like it's supposed to look like there's a shirt underneath. I'm not sure how I feel about it. I'll probably like cut that out and then just like finish the edge so it doesn't fray. But yeah, I really like this. I have plans on doing something to it. I want to make it like a Heather sweater, you know, if you know the song. And just kind of like either embroider a lyric on to it. I'm not sure that will work with the fabric though, or something like that. The next category are YouTubers that I have been loving. First we have Conan Gray. Next we have Conan Gray, and third we have Conan Gray. Just kidding, there are some others, but it's mostly Conan. He's just really nice and just kind of like a breath of fresh air, you know? I like to watch him when I'm sad or when I'm happy. I just like to watch him 24/7, you know? And he has some really great videos. He doesn't post anymore, or like at least like the content that he used to. Now it's mostly just music videos and stuff. The most aesthetic human ever. He has a wonderful personality, a very beautiful soul, and his content, it ranges anywhere from like, he does lots of vlogs, at least he did, lots of covers, lots of, just a whole lot of everything. I'm sure you'll find something you like there. Just go check him out, please. And then also a bit of this YouTuber called Annie Long has been. I don't know where I was going with that. But I've been watching her lately. I like her videos. She's quite young and she makes these like videos about productivity. I like to watch her to motivate myself to do stuff, like actually clean my room for once. all of the YouTubers I mentioned will be linked in the description. Yeah, I hope that you, I don't know, find some new creators through my list. Okay, next is the category you've all been waiting for, which is AG. Okay, don't tell my other dolls, even though they're literally sitting like 5 feet away from me. But I felt a really strong connection to Kaya recently. It's probably because I've been working on the Kaya Etsy release. Ooh. Ho ho. I haven't said that anywhere, so that's why I make those weird voices after. Yeah, I've been working on an Etsy release, like, her style. So if you like what she's wearing right now, you should go check it out. I would say Kaya is my favorite doll for them. My favorite AGTuber is Forever and Always. I haven't been watching a lot of AGTube recently. I don't know, sometimes it just happens. And I go through phases where I don't really watch it that much. But my favorite AGTuber is Forever and Always. Heart makes some really awesome content. I love her. She's just really great. Next, my favorite AGIG-er is this new person to AGIG. Her username is Kate's Kit. Here are some of her photos. They're so beautiful. I love her editing style. Just very simplistic, but just beautiful nonetheless. Next is my favorite books of the month, or favorite book, because I haven't been reading much lately. It is The Hunger Games. I'm obsessed. I finished it a couple days ago. So good. I'm late to the game, you know. This book has been around for a while. It's very popular. Everyone has probably already read it, except me. So if you haven't, though, please check it out. It's very good. Very engaging and, like, pulls you in. Each chapter ends with like a little cliffhanger, so it's very addicting as well. I've lost lots of sleep because of it, because I just read and read. And I also watched the movie yesterday, which is also really good. I prefer the book though. I don't know. They're both really great though. Next are my favorite drinks. This is a bit of a weird category, but I don't know. Like, I've just had weird drink preferences that I haven't. I usually just drink water, is what I'm trying to say. This month I've been addicted to hot chocolate, but mainly while I'm working on the Etsy release, which is kind of weird. I don't know. But I make it a special way. I do like a little bit of cocoa powder, and then some sugar, and then like a bit of milk or like milk substitute or something like that. It's very good. Maybe if I'm feeling a bit bougie, I might add in a couple chocolate chips. It's very good. I prefer that to like the store-bought stuff, and it doesn't take much extra time. Next is this juice called Cran Raspberry Juice. I've hated it all my life, like with a burning passion. But then one day my sister and I were just making dinner, and I was like, hey, can I have a sip of your drink? And that's what it was, and it's really good. It's very refreshing. I really like it. That's a really weird category. It probably won't be in any other videos, but I just thought I'd mention it. Next is the final category, which is miscellaneous. Crafting, I've been obsessed with. I've been in a very crafty mood all month. I've done macrame, pin making, and lots of sewing, of course. My favorite place is the pool in our creek. It's quite deep, so it's great for swimming. Last one would be laying on our trampoline and looking at the clouds. I just love it.
Come with me, forget about your fears. The world could all be yours if you stop being a realist. There's no need to stress, you'll be a success. Back at the treehouse, let's go back to the tree.